Welcome back to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. Well, we just got done our second press conference from the New Horizons team from showing us images of Ultima Thule. We got to see some beautiful stereo images, and here to talk a little bit about that with me is Dr. Kirby Runyon. Kirby, how are you doing today, sir?
I'm fine, thanks. It's another exciting day exploring the Kuiper Belt.
So tell me a little bit more about what we saw today and what you saw today, and I understand you're a geologist, right? So I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit about, or talk a little bit about what you plan to be doing with the data as it trickles in.
Yeah, so as especially the high resolution data sets from the LORI camera come in from the spacecraft, we're going to be focusing especially where we think the geology on Ultima Thule is going to be most pronounced. And right now we're kind of thinking that might be in the general area of the neck, where the two lobes, Ultima and Thule, are joined at the hip, as it were.
That little bright ring in the middle, right?
Exactly, yeah. We think the slopes there are really high, and so you'd have a lot of downhill slope movement of boulders or dust or something, and we want to see what kind of geologic landforms have kind of accumulated where those lobes have come together.
When it's kind of interesting to think a little bit about, because you mentioned rolling downhill, and I thought maybe we could have a little bit of fun with the gravity of the situation, because we are talking about two objects, each with their own individual centers of mass, and then there's a system center of mass. How close is the system center of mass to the neck?
The rotation axis is displaced from the neck inside the larger lobe a little bit. Probably approximately halfway between the ends of the two lobes, I would guess, approximately there. And that would be also where the illustrations you've seen from James Keen that show the rotation axis popping out through Ultima Thule, It's somewhere in the wider part of the body.
Right, okay, so material from, do you think material from Thule would be, more material would be rolling down from Thule onto the neck than from Ultima, or do you think it could be a combination of both?
We don't know the exact ratios of the downhill slope from either lobe. It's probably some combination of both. And in fact, James Keen, who also produced our artwork, is also a PhD planetary geophysicist. And so he's done modeling of the slopes and the gravity, showing that the slopes are steepest relative to the gravity in the area of the neck. So we'd expect the most downslope movement probably in the neck area, which is why I think it's going to be a very interesting place to look geologically once we get higher resolution pictures back in a few weeks.
Wow. So and that's got to be it, right? I mean, we only have the low resolution images. These are a thumbnail quality images, right? Is there anything that you're already piqued about? I mean, is this like the worst tease in the world to see such almost but not quite science-worthy images?
So our highest resolution pictures now are around 140 meters per pixel, and it's exactly that. It's a tease. It's both satisfying and it's frustrating, because we see a little bit of what it looks like, but we don't see enough of what we really want to just sink our teeth into geologically.
Yeah. So okay, now when it comes in, What are you looking for? What are you hoping to find? Is there a betting pool? What are you hoping for at this point, Kirby?
I'll be happy with anything right now, but I'm really interested in the sedimentary geology of the space between the neck. Going to be looking for things like any wind-blown ripples. Probably not there, but we're going to look for them. We saw them on Comet 67P. Uh-huh. We're going to be looking for downhill slope streaks or slope movements. We're going to be looking for ejecta from any impact event, so things that has gotten scooped out of the subsurface and sprayed across the surface. We're going to be looking for those kinds of boulder streaks or ejecta distributions like that.
That sounds exciting. And you get to start really digging into this about when?
It's going to be several weeks from now, probably early February.
Early February, okay. So this has got to feel like the longest January in history for you.
I can't believe it's only January 3rd. It feels like it's been January for 2 weeks already.
Yeah, I guess so. Overall, is everything working kind of the way you had hoped it would work? Is it kind of meh? Is it kind of better? Or is it, where would you say it is on the fun meter?
Oh, it's definitely pegged at 10 on the fun meter. The team has gelled really well. We've been working together for a long time.
Yeah.
We're having a lot of fun in our back room. It's intense, but I draw a lot of energy off that intensity, and speculation and the inside jokes that crop up during that time are a lot of fun as well. So the team has really come together. Monday in particular was a lot of fun. It was a 14-hour day, really long day, just pouring over.
Oh, yeah, New Year's Eve. Right.
Oh, well, New Year's Eve and New Year's Day were both, they just blur together, but they were so much fun as we were just pouring over all this new data and working together and trying to churn out new results as fast as we could.
So when Alan Stern mentioned that now we're at conjunction, which means Ultima and New Horizons is on the other side of the sun from Earth. We're going into a radio blackout. Are you planning to get any more data between now and the start of that blackout, or are you pretty much just done for now and waiting?
My understanding is that we're basically done. Transmitting through the sun's solar corona is not a good idea. So we're basically in radio silence for about 5 days, is my understanding.
Well, now wait, they're flying the Parker Solar Probe right across the hall from New Horizons. Why don't you go and talk to them and say, hey, can you relay the data from New Horizons?
Well, it'd be great if the spacecraft could do that, but that's a great idea.
Wouldn't that be nice,
That'd
right?
Be
yeah. Oh, Kirby, man, this has been great. By the way, I want to give a shout out to Athena Brensberger.
Hey, Athena.
Hey, Athena from Astro Athens. If you're not subscribed to her channel, please do subscribe. Extremely enthusiastic. And the reason why I'm shouting her out is because she was very kind enough to introduce me to Kirby ahead of this week's event. So, Athena, thank you.
Thanks
thank you very much, Athena. Yeah, we're so glad to have you, and thank you again, Dr. Runyon,
thank
Dr.
You,
Kirby. All right, take care, Kirby. See ya. Bye. There he goes, Dr. Kirby Runyon, planetary geologist on New Horizons. Can't wait to see what's next. Let's go talk to somebody else.